not just explaining the world, but changing it. You're listening to WBPU LP St. Petersburg.
Everywhere you turn, I'll be a destruction. I'm on
Gypsy.
Fire, flood, farming for the land. You don't see what I'm on. Wars after wars, at that time.
All right now.
What I'm going, J. Douglas?
For the world is trouble.
We need to fix it.
And living ain't easy.
Go take it, that make we.
World is trouble.
We are going to fix it.
You got to believe.
Go take it, that make we. Like a firestorm, only Jack can come. Hungry bellies in the sea, impact the water, the air quality can't even breathe. So Father, we call on you, only you know what to do. Choo-choo, tell them now.
Cast away all evil spells.
Fire burn.
Don't play a hero, you'll end down in hell.
Hey, hey.
You've got your troubles and I've got mine. Let's work.
Uhuru, you are listening to Dire Sport Music on Black Power 96 with Norman Otis Richmond and Melinda Francis, and we are we'd like to thank two people, like we thank every time we come on the air. We would like to thank Archibald Shep for giving us the concept of Dire Sport Music made in the West but not of the West. And like we say every week, we cheat because we play music from all over the world, since imperialism took African people all over the world, including the South Pacific. It probably can be argued that there were African people in the South Pacific before the other black folks were taken there, but we will continue. And we are going to have a great show for you today. We're raising funds. This is a fun. We're raising funds for Black Power 96, and we will want you to get your checkbooks. That's dated. I'm dating myself. However you guys pay money now with this, with all this scientific stuff out there now. But we are we're going to be talking to Gerald Horn per usual. We're going to have the Jazz Zone per usual. We're going to be paying tribute to Max Roach, who would have turned 100 years. He would be a century old. He was born in 19, same year as my dear mother, 1924. And we are going to have try to have a great show for you today. And Gerald Horn is going to give us a report from he did a book launch in Leimert Park, Africa Town in Los Angeles yesterday. We're going to be talking to him about that. But we are getting ready to play our first song, and we had a great interview last week with Bobby Rush. We're going to be playing. We had the interview with Bobby Rush recently, but we're going to be giving you a little bit of that as well. But first, we're going to listen to Mr. Rush, and he's going to do a song called "I Can't Find My Keys," which was he recorded when he was under contract to Philadelphia International. That was the label of Gamble and Huff, and I believe that Mr. Huff produced this particular track, "I Can't Find My Keys."
Here I am, all dressed up, clean as I can be. Gotta pick up my baby by the 7:45. I can't find my key. My baby, she expecting me by the 7:45. We're gonna make love tonight, and I don't wanna be late. I love it everywhere for my keys, every place I thought they would be. I look under the rug, behind the couch, but I still can't find my key, y'all. Somebody, won't you help me to find my keys? Somebody help me, help me, help me to find my keys. Somebody help me, help me, come on and help me to find my key, y'all. Gotta find my keys, y'all, yeah. Without my keys, I'm a lonely man. Girl, I'm helpless like a man in quicksand. Help me to find my keys.
to my door, key to my car, key to my baby's home. I lost the key to my deposit box, lost the key to the telephone. Without my keys, oh, I'm a lonely man. Help me find my
You are listening to Diasporic Music on Black Power 96, Norman Richmond, Melinda Francis. Lisa Watson is on the buttons, and we just heard from Johnny Guitar Watson. Johnny Guitar Watson, it was his birthday a couple of days ago. He was born in Houston, Texas, many years ago, and he came to California and went to a Jefferson High School in Los Angeles. And Jefferson High School, many people went there. Barry White went there. Roy Ayers went there. Etta James went there. On the negative, well, I should say Dorothy Dandridge went there. Dorothy Dandridge was known for being a beautiful sister and a quite a woman, but her looks, people talk about how gorgeous she was, but she was she had a great mind as well. And also, it was on the negative side, it was also the school that produced Ralph Bunche, Uncle Ralph Bunche. Now, Uncle Ralph Bunche was he was in the mix when they killed Patrice Lumumba, and the state gave him many, 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 many awards. And He was born in Detroit, but he came to Los Angeles and finished school at Jefferson High School. And Johnny Guitar Watson, that song, Asante Sana Bibi, that's Swahili for thank you very much. And I must admit that I think I was responsible for that particular song because Eduardo Monlane, the leader of Frelimo, liberation movement in Mozambique, his son came to California, Eduardo Monlane Jr., and his sister used to be a background singer for Stevie Wonder. And Ayuko Babu, who was the founder of the Pan-African Film Festival, introduced me to Eduardo Monlane Jr. And he came by my house, and my sister and mother prepared him dinner and da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And Eduardo Monlane is a fair-skinned guy, or as, you know, using the language of black people in America, he's a high yellow guy. So my mother was saying that she thought he was going to be, you know, dark, since he was from Africa. This was many, many, many years ago. So I was explaining to her that, you know, that African people, you know, some of the, I think the San people in Southern Africa, they were quite light skinned. And I was always explaining to her that, you know, African people came in all shades, blue, black, and, you know, as we used to say, high yellow. But anyway, Eduardo Monlane, I took him to meet Johnny Guitar Watson, and Johnny Guitar Watson inspired him, or he, Johnny Guitar Watson, after he met Eduardo Monlane, they hit it off pretty well, and Johnny Guitar Watson came up with that song, Asante Sana. And we are going to, we're fundraising. This is our fundraising for Black Power 96, and we are going to give you some information shortly, but we are going to listen to Bobby Rush. Bobby Rush is going to help us do some fundraising, and check this out. Bobby Rush. Music, and we were listening to a medley by Bobby Bland, Johnny Taylor, and a young man who is on the line with us right now, Mr. Bobby Rush. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing great, good. I just love you to death, cause you call me young man, you know. But
you're only 90 years old, so you're a young man.
That's right. 90 years young, you know.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I retract that. You're right. I stand corrected. 90 years.
Yeah,
this is
a great day, you know. You're talking about Major Jackson, you're talking about Bobby Bland, my friend, who was 3 years older than I. And we were very good friends for 69 years. We were solid friends for 69 years.
Oh, boy.
And talk 2-3 times a week for 60 years.
Uh-huh.
That's a long time, hard-earned friendship, you know? Yeah.
You know something? No, go ahead. I cut you off. Let me shut up.
You didn't cut me off. Go ahead and talk to me.
I understand Bobby was married to his last wife was a sister from Jamaica, and they said that she looked after him. She kept all of the scoundrels away from him. I know you know about that, right?
Yes, she kept all of, because he called them scoundrels. That way she called them scoundrels. But anyway, it was just, she wanted to make sure that another lady look at Bobby Bland, you know, just like any woman would do. That's protection. And she didn't mean anything about it other than this is mine, you know. And she was a good person. I know her very well, and I know the family. I know the her children and the grandchildren, and so on and so on. It's just a good, a lovely family. And regardless of the thing goes on in life, ups and downs, but you make the best out of them that you know how to make out of life. And Bobby Bland was my friend, and I can say that. And he was a hell of an entertainer, and a musician, and an artist, and just I can't find a good enough word to describe how Bobby Bland was to his public, to the audience, to his fans, to his friends, and definitely to me.
Well, he had a reputation he was like a Solomon Burke. He satisfied his audience always. I remember he put
and
on a good show.
Satisfied me too, cause he always. You know, Bobby Bland, he would do a little squawk thing. You know, that
into
comes
the squawk, into that squall. A lot of people don't.
Yeah,
a lot of our people, middle class folks don't. I used to love that squall. I couldn't. I always wanted to squall, but I never could.
You can squall if you got out into a pastelum with a goat or something running at you. You squalled in, so you went on country boy. You know. get out before a snake get at you. You squall. You holler. Yeah.
Well, you know that.
I'm so glad. Go ahead. Squall came from what? I didn't know that.
No, I said the squall came from Bob. That was he got that squall from Aretha's daddy, C.L. Franklin. That's what Bobby got.
Yeah.
From.
That's what he said, because he was a preacher. He used to squall like that when he was a preacher. You know.
Right.
Rather than C.L. Franklin. You know. But nevertheless, where he got it from, he used it well, and that was a thing stuck with him, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I believe it was an accidental kind of thing when he was doing it. He wasn't doing it to make a name for himself being a squaller. I think he was just doing it because it's something he wanted to do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But it latched on to him, stuck to him, you know. Let me say before we get too far in this interview, let me thank you for what you have done for this music. And what you're doing, what you plan to do, because what you say about me and the music that I play and the people who play the music is what people perceive all of us to be, especially me. I want to thank you for what you've done and what you're still doing.
I would like to thank you, sir. And we're going to be raising money next week on the station. And we have, people, Bobby Rush lovers, we want them to support our station, and we don't want to support Bobby Rush. We want people to go out, buy your book, buy your records, and definitely come see you whenever, wherever you are on the planet Earth.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You've been to China and stuff, right? You've been all
over
the world.
Oh, God, yeah. I was one of the first black men who went to China and worked in China and got my name and my pencil signed on the Great Walls of China, you know, and got my ideal of being free. Speaking about being free, my last record up for a Grammy now, and the first song was on that, I'm free, look at me. I got the shackles off my feet and the chains off my mind. Because I'm talking about, I start off talking about the things I used to do in Louisiana, which I was born, I don't do anymore. I used to carry water 15 days, 15 died, for 15, used to carry water when I was about 15 years old, and left for 50 cents a day. I used to pick cotton in the cotton field where I used to live. I'm still picking cotton, and I don't mind it because I own a piece of the field. That's what I mean by being free, you know? And I have mm-hmm. lived long enough to understand and know that I don't know anything, because when a man tell what he know, he won't talk long because man don't know nothing. But one thing I can tell you that I want the people to listen to your station, keep listening to you, because you bring good news and good information about the blues and the people who do the blues. And when you're coming up with fundraiser for the station, keep the station on the air, it's a good thing to do, because you're one of the few stations around who still bring the news about the blues and keep it alive. Because I want people to support you and the station, because when you're gone, man, we're in trouble by keeping this blues thing alive. And the blues is the root. It's the mother of all music. And if you don't like the blues, you probably don't like your mama.
I want to let Melinda ask you one question, then we're going to let you go, sir.
Yeah, let the lady ask me anything she wants. I love lady asking me things.
Yeah, I mean, you were saying that you're up for a Grammy. Is there any new music at all?
Yeah, this is the new. I'm up for a Grammy with the new music. New music has been All My Love for You. The whole album is up. The song is up, and I dropped a single just yesterday. Dropped a single yesterday, you know, called "I'm an Undercover Lover." I do everything I can and I want to, and all I can undercover. Yeah, just like Jane Bond. Yeah, undercover lover, you know. Yeah, and that just dropped on yesterday, and you'll be hearing more about it. It's called Undercover Lover. It's a pre-thing that I did maybe 10 or 12 years ago, and I reissued it. So people like it, and I just reissued it, you know. But the record and the album of the and Artist of the Year and the Performance of the Year is I'm up for that for the Blues Award, but I'm also up. I'm nominated 2 categories in the Grammys. So got my fingers crossed. You guys hope the best for me that I bring it home.
Bring it on home. Bring it on home to me. But I want to say that you are Dolomite. You made a you were in the film Dolomite, my man Rudy Ray Moore, right?
Man, that was my best friend.